Cement is the second most consumed substance on Earth after water. It is a gray powder used to make concrete, and it is also used to lay bricks, pave roads, build dams, or line reservoirs. It is the glue that holds houses and buildings firmly in place. Behind this product lies a huge history of giant furnaces and powerful explosives, but how are millions of tons of cement made in Latin America's largest factory? One of the most surprising facts about cement is that it has been in use for thousands of years. The ancient Egyptians used a primitive form of cement to build the pyramids, and the Romans used a similar material to construct their famous aqueducts and colosseums. Another interesting fact is that cement is actually not a natural substance. It is made by heating limestone, clay, and other minerals to very high temperatures in a kiln. This process causes a chemical reaction that produces the powdery substance that we know as cement. Cement is also incredibly strong, which is why it is such a popular material for construction. It can withstand heavy loads and extreme weather conditions, making it an ideal choice for everything from roads and bridges to buildings and homes. One of the challenges with using cement, however, is that it is not very environmentally friendly. The production of cement releases a significant amount of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, which contributes to climate change. As a result, many researchers and scientists are working on developing new, more sustainable materials to replace cement in construction. Despite its drawbacks, cement remains one of the most important and widely used building materials in the world. It has helped to shape our cities and infrastructure, and it will continue to play a vital role in construction for many years to come. In Mexico, one of the world's largest cement producers is found, and this factory looks like an industrial city, but it is actually a single plant, the largest in all of Latin America. More than 3 million tons of cement are produced annually in Cemex's factory. Worldwide, the company produces an astonishing 94 million tons. The whole process starts in the limestone quarry. The limestone that is close to the surface has a high content of silica, iron, and aluminum oxide, while at greater depths, limestone is pure. The quarry is located 2,500 meters above sea level, and large amounts of limestone are required to manufacture cement. This place covers 800 hectares, but explosives are needed to extract limestone from the surface. Workers drill the rock and place explosives in the holes. For safety reasons, workers must stand behind the area they are blowing, keeping a distance of at least 50 meters. A concentrated explosion destroys the mountain slope, releasing up to 200,000 tons of limestone. After the explosion, shovels come into action and load the rocks into 90-ton dump trucks. A shovel armed with a 12-cubic-meter bucket is responsible for picking up the rocks, and it can pick up 18 tons with just one scoop. It only takes a few scoops to fill the 90-ton truck, which then takes its load to the nearby cement plant. It's time to convert limestone into cement, but the first problem is that the rocks are too large, so trucks dump tons of limestone into a giant crusher where a 67-ton mortar crushes 1,000 tons per hour. The crusher reduces the size of the rocks to that of a tennis ball. When the rock exits the crusher, it moves on conveyor belts to the plant. All of the factory's activities are organized from a central control room. At the plant's control center, the entry of the different materials necessary to manufacture cement can be controlled. The basic recipe is limestone, clay, and iron, and these ingredients come from six giants that are introduced into the plant. The ingredients are too dense to make cement, so they are sent to a mill. At the base, three enormous crushers grind the rubble into a fine powder. Once the 4,500 horsepower crusher is operational, it grinds up to 350 tons of rubble per hour. Next, the water and volatile gases in the freshly ground powder must be removed, and this requires a lot of heat. An enormous rotating tube is used to heat the powder. This tube is one of the largest kilns on Earth, and it is the main machine used to manufacture cement. The powder's temperature is 80 degrees when it enters the kiln, and in 40 seconds, it is 10 times hotter. This is the start of the process of joining the minerals inside the kiln. A large burner generates a lot of heat, which cooks the kiln at 1,400 degrees Celsius, a temperature higher than molten lava. As the limestone moves along the rotating tube, it dries and decomposes into calcium oxide and releases CO2 in a process called calcination. The ingredients undergo further solid-state reaction, the last of which causes the mixture to clump together into lumps called clinker. The clinker must now be transformed into powdered cement. When the clinker comes out of the oven, large fans cool it down to a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius. It is important to cool the clinker quickly to obtain quality cement. The last stage in cement manufacturing is the final crushing. Gypsum is added to the clinker, the amount varying according to the type of cement being produced. Gypsum delays the setting time of the cement so that it can be worked for up to 2 hours before hardening. Afterwards, it is sent to a second giant mill. Inside the mill, there are thousands of metal balls bouncing and pulverizing the clinker until it becomes a fine powder. Once the metal balls have done their job, the fine powder is sucked up through a tube and sent to the packaging area. Each of these machines fills more than 120 tons of cement. Now they are passing one by one from the conveyor belts to an automatic stacker that piles the bags in heaps. Then, a fleet of forklifts loads the bags onto trucks. Some bags are shipped throughout the country, and others are distributed by train to other countries. Cement is known for its incredible strength and durability, making it an essential material in the construction industry. Its ability to withstand tremendous pressure and weight is one of the reasons why it is widely used in building structures, bridges, roads, and other infrastructure projects. One of the most impressive things about cement is how much weight it can carry. The amount of weight that cement can bear depends on several factors, such as the quality of the cement, the type of aggregate used, and the thickness and composition of the concrete. For instance, regular concrete, which is a mixture of cement, sand, and gravel, can typically support a weight of about 3,000 to 4,000 pounds per square inch, psi. However, reinforced concrete, which has steel bars or mesh embedded in it, can carry much heavier loads. The steel provides additional support and helps distribute the weight evenly, allowing the concrete to carry up to 20,000 psi. In some cases, concrete can even carry weight beyond what we might imagine. For example, the Hoover Dam, located on the border between Nevada and Arizona in the United States, is made of concrete and can support the weight of the Colorado River, which runs through it. The dam is 726 feet tall, and its base is 660 feet thick, which allows it to withstand the tremendous pressure of the water, which can reach up to 45,000 psi. Another impressive example of cement strength is the Burj Khalifa, the world's tallest building, located in Dubai. The building's foundation is made of reinforced concrete, which can carry an astonishing weight of up to 12,000 psi. The foundation alone weighs over 110,000 tons and is 50 meters deep. The next time you see a concrete structure, remember the tremendous weight it can carry thanks to the power of cement. Like the video if you enjoyed it and share it with someone else who might be interested. Also, subscribe to this channel by turning on notifications to continue learning. Bye bye.